people have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is known around the world for its history, cultural heritage, and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India is surely one of the most popular tourist destinations around the world. This is majorly because of its wide variety of geographical terrains, which could be easily visited with a shoestring budget. Famous for its beaches, the state of Goa is a tourist magnet that attracts beach enthusiasts and water sports lovers from all around the world. With the country returning back to normalcy steadily amid the pandemic, tourism has now resumed in one of the most popular tourism spots in the country. Have a look.
The world is very well acquainted with the scenic beauty of Goan beaches, which are famous for its long coastline covered in a golden blanket of sand. Surrounded by the Arabian Sea on one side and land on the other, the region boasts of around 30 beaches, imprints of Indo-Portuguese culture, carnivals and scrumptious seafood, which have the capability of leaving the visitors awestruck. With the country returning back to normal amid the worldwide pandemic, tourism activities have resumed in Goa, which is turning out to be a treat for all the travel enthusiasts.
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है और यहाँ का एटमॉस्फेयर भी बहुत अच्छा है. हाँ, क्लाइमेट बहुत अच्छा है. हमने अभी बोटिंग किया, पैराशूट का ही किया, राइड किया है अभी, और बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है.
One of the most favorite destinations among tourists in Goa is its pristine beaches. Spread over an incredible coastline of over 100 kilometers, they offer serene views where tourists often relax in solitude under the sun. This is the famous Kalankut beach of northern Goa, and it is popular among tourists both from India and abroad due to a variety of water sports that are performed on this beach. After a long pandemic break, tourists have finally started returning to this flagship beach to enjoy water sports like parasailing, water surfing, banana ride, jet skiing and more. They can be seen enjoying scrumptious Goan dishes and having a gala time.
It was really nice, and you know, all the rides are very much nice, and of course, and currently the prices also not so high, and it was really good, and even weather it's supposed to us very much.
When I came to Goa, actually I came in plane over here. It was my first time coming to Goa, and I was so happy, so excited.
Apart from the sunny beaches and adventurous water sport activities, the state of Goa has much more to offer, which makes it the most ideal holiday location. The first one in the list is Goa Carnival, which is organized around the month of February. It provides an insight into the vibrant Goan culture and celebrates ancient traditions that hold a major space in the history and formation of the state. As part of the carnival, people throng the streets along the Mandovi River in Panji to get a glance of the float parade led by King Momo, considered as the king of carnivals in Latin American festivals. Cruises are the other reason why visitors love to visit Goa. There are many different locations for cruising in Goa, including Chapora, Miramar and Hawaii. Houseboat cruising in Goa also offer a unique and memorable experience to the visitors. Then comes the churches and old Goa that are major attraction. The real beauty of Goa lies in its oldest side of the state that covers age-old architectural marvels like forts and churches. Churches in Goa showcase stunning Portuguese designs expressing the history and legacy of the state. Goa is one of the places around the world that showcases prime beauty throughout the year. Youngsters too love to visit Goa to enjoy a happening nightlife filled with nightclubs, bars and night beach parties.
Mumbai, the mega city of India, houses a mix of religions. Apart from Hindus, Mumbai has a concentration of Muslims, Zoroastrians, Christians, Jains and Buddhists. Religious conviction and secularism goes hand in hand in the city. Bringing before you an example of it is the city's Mahim Dargah, which has become a utopia of communal harmony.
Situated in the bustle of Mahim Bazaar in Mumbai, the domed mausoleum of Hazrat Makhdoom Ali Mahimi stands tall, overlooking Mahim Bay and the ramparts of Mahim Fort in its picturesque background. For centuries, this green and white structure has remained a beacon of communal harmony and brotherhood. The Dargah dons a special air of tranquility and peace when devotees coming from across faiths throng the shrine to pay their obeisance to the 14th century saint.
लोग तो हर कौम के आते हैं, आते ही रहते हैं। जुमेरात और इतवार को तो इतनी भीड़ रहती है कि पब्लिक को अंदर जाने के लिए एक घंटा लगता है। समझे कि ना वो बंबई के बादशाह बोले जाते हैं। पूरे बंबई में बड़ी दरगाह यही है और इनका ही उर्स सब में भारी रहता है। हिंदुस्तान में सबसे ज्यादा लोग यहीं आते हैं।
A flight of steps ending in an arched opening takes devotees inside the well-lit mausoleum, dominated by two large graves, that of Makhdoom Sahib in the middle and that of his mother to its left. It is not an unusual sight to see people of all faiths, both young and old, offering chadars at this holy dargah of this great Sufi saint. Many devotees believe that tying a sacred thread on the silver-coated railings present in the premises of this dargah can sanctify them and could fulfill their lifelong desires.
बाबा सबके लिए अच्छा ही करते हैं। हम लोगों को बाबा पे बहुत भरोसा है।
कितने सालों से आप आ रही हैं और क्या?
3-4 साल से आ रहे हैं हम लोग। बहुत विश्वास है बाबा पे।
Hazrat Makhdoom Ali Mahimi was born in 1372 into a family of Arab travelers from Iraq who settled down on the island of Mahim, now known as Mumbai. He was the first commentator of the Holy Quran and Tafsir-e-Rahmani in India, which is unique among all the commentary of Quran known to scholars. He is revered by both Hindus and Muslims, and after his death in 1431, he was buried in Mahim, the site which later became a renowned dargah. Every year on the 13th day of Shawwal as per the Muslim calendar, annual Urs or Mahim Dargah fair is organized in the memory of the saint, which is attended by a number of devotees across the globe, making it a platform of religious diversity.
Mahim Dargah is a platform of humanity. It's a symbol of communal harmony. Yeah, it's a her gender ka aadmi, every gender people are over here, every caste, every religion people, they come here and pay their respect. In fact, we have also had inter-religious faith people coming over here. We have different conferences held of different community. Now the new ideas what Mahim Dargah, since they are being a professional, 2007 they have achieved ISO certification, first Dargah in the world to get that time. So now we are contacting all the community people, different community people, like Catholics are there, Buddhists are there, Jains are there, Sadajis are there. We are trying to make a platform for brotherhood also. So communal harmony plus brotherhood plus this place give always take care of a human life, which they always say that is of paramount importance to us. So we take care of the security also. There are many other works what Mahim Dargah is doing, but the base of Mahim Dargah is humanity and communal harmony.
For ages, the Sufi saints like Makhdoom Ali Mahimi have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
India's first solar miniature train is attracting visitors in Trivandrum city. Visitors were seen taking rides in the train as they took proper measures to prevent the spread of coronavirus.
It's very good for all people, especially for children, and also for it is a most important, most attractive feature in Trivandrum district.
The 2.5-kilometer solar-powered train inaugurated by Chief of Kerala State Pinaraya Vijayan at the Veli Tourist Village has a fully equipped rail system with a station, tunnel and ticket office. More than 60 heads of foreign missions visited manufacturing facilities in Hyderabad as one of the world's leading pharmaceutical centers steps up production of COVID-19 vaccines. India is reviewing applications from Pfizer Inc., AstraZeneca and Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech for emergency use. The foreign delegates visited Biotech's facilities in Hyderabad, where the firm is developing a shot called Covaxin in collaboration with the government-run Indian Council of Medical Research. The delegates also visited Biological E Limited's facility, where the firm is developing a vaccine in collaboration with Baylor College of Medicine in Houston, Texas, and US-based Dynavax Technologies Corp., the sources said. India may approve some coronavirus vaccines over the next few weeks, and an estimated 300 million people would be inoculated in the first tranche. Indian Navy launched the Project 17A stealth frigate INS Himgiri in eastern Kolkata city. The ship was launched at the GRSE yard in the presence of Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat.
Time has come now to look at the future of war fighting, imbibing technology into our systems. That is something we are looking at. We have got adequate forces, adequate reserves available to counter any threat or challenges that we may face on the northern borders.
INS Himgiri has been built by Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers and is the second ship Nilgiri class stealth guided missile frigates.
India is a country where different religious communities reside harmoniously and play an important role towards each other's upliftment. An example showcasing this brotherhood recently came to limelight in the Bengaluru city of Karnataka, where a Muslim man has donated a piece of his land to a Hindu temple. In a remarkable example of religious harmony, a Bengaluru-based Muslim businessman has donated land for expansion of the complex of a Hindu temple. This friendly gesture by HMG Pasha, who is a cargo business owner, has won hearts of many people. Pasha has donated land for the expansion of Hanuman Temple at Hoskote Taluk, some 35 kilometers away from Bengaluru city.
हमारा मजहब बोलता है, हमारा कमेटी बोलता है, आबाद करो, मस्जिद आबाद करो, मंदिर आबाद करो, चर्च को आबाद करो, उसको जो होना आप आपके हाथ में होने से सहूलत दो. सब हमारे को लगा ये ठीक नहीं है, इसको थोड़ा बड़ा करेंगे, अच्छा करेंगे
मंदिर को.
तब हमें सोचा, तब हम नहीं बना सकते ना उसको मंदिर को. तब जो उसका कमेटी है, वो मंदिर का कमेटी है, उनको बुलाकर हम बात की है.
Basha's family-owned 3-acre-sized land is located adjacent to the Hanuman temple. Devotees had been offering their prayers at this temple for around 3 decades and were struggling to perform some rituals which required more space. As a solution to the problem, the temple trust asked Basha, who eagerly donated about 1,634 square feet of land for the expansion of the temple campus. Basha's family members and friends have also laid their support in his decision.
ये तो इंसानियत है, ये जो चीज है इंसानियत है, इसमें भेदभाव कुछ भी नहीं है. इधर जो है हम लोग इधर ही पैदा हुए हैं, हमारे फादर ग्रैंडफादर सब कुछ इधर के ही. हम लोग जिससे भी हमारा फ्रेंडशिप है हिंदू सर्कल में, ये है मुसलमान, और वो हमारा घर को हिंदू भी आते हैं, हम लोग उनका फेस्टिवल को हम उनके घर पे जाते हैं. ऐसा हमारा पहले से नेचर है, हमारा जात बात नहीं है, जस्ट हम इंसान है, बस उतना ही.
इट इज एग्जांपल्स लाइक दीस दैट प्रूव दैट द सिटीजंस ऑफ आवर कंट्री स्टैंड यूनिफाइड despite of all the religious and cultural differences and are always available to help each other in difficult times like these. Be it skiing in snow-covered hills or biking through picturesque landscapes, Jammu and Kashmir offers a host of options for the adventure lovers. In the recent past, a lot of new adventure-oriented activities have been introduced in the Union Territory to attract the adrenaline junkies. The latest addition to the list is a snow slalom cycling that was organized in the picturesque Gulmarg town. Have a look.
Covered with sheets of snow, Kashmir's popular tourist destination, Gulmarg, became the hub of adventure enthusiasts as it hosted the first ever snow slalom cycling event. Organized by Adventure Tour Operators Association of Kashmir and Mountain Biking Association in collaboration with the Department of Tourism, the event aimed to promote adventure tourism in the valley, which is badly affected due to the pandemic. One of the most popular ski resorts in India, Gulmarg keeps on opening new options for the adventure lovers to satisfy their appetite, and this snow cycling is a new one in the list.
Kashmir mein pehli baar, balki main bataun India mein pehli baar jo snow cycling ka cycling slalom hua, to wo ek zabardast cheez rahi aur bada maza aaya sir. Mere paas alfaaz nahi hai, I'm speechless.
A number of participants turned out for the event who put on their noblest tires and began pedaling on the snow-covered surface. They praised the organizers and said that more such events should be organized in the valley on a regular basis.
ज़रूरी है सर ये सारी एक्टिविटीज़ करने के लिए, क्योंकि एक पॉजिटिव मैसेज जाता है ऑल अक्रॉस इंडिया, ऑल अक्रॉस वर्ल्ड कि आप आइए यहाँ पे कश्मीर में, स्पेशली गुलमर्ग विच इज़ नोन फॉर यू नो द एडवेंचर टूरिज्म, स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग यू नो विंटर्स, और अभी तो बर्फ़ भी बहुत ज़्यादा यहाँ पे हो चुकी है और हो भी रही है करंटली. तो आई थिंक पीपल शुड कम एंड एन्जॉय हियर इन गुलमर्ग, स्पेशली जो आज हमने देखा यहाँ पे साइकिलिंग से रिलेटेड इवेंट्स थे या स्केटिंग या स्कीइंग से रिलेटेड इवेंट्स हैं, पीपल शुड कम एंड एन्जॉय हियर.
Snow Slalom cycling event was a great initiative to promote streak of adventure and provide a platform to the local talent to further compete a national and international arena.
Last but not the least, we introduce you to our latest edition, Asia in Focus, which will bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings across Asia.
When Japan announced a state of emergency due to the coronavirus pandemic this year, citizens got busy in decluttering their homes to pass the time. As a result, second-hand luxury goods market started booming. Buy-Sell Technologies Co. Limited, the company used by Iwama, which collects goods from people's homes and resells them online, has been one of the beneficiaries of country's pandemic-induced tiding.
在宅の時間というのが非常に増えてですね、まあ、皆さん家にいる時間の中でいろんなものを整理したり、まあ、日本でいうと断捨離という言葉があるんですけれども、とにかく生活をミニマイズしていく、まあ、こういったですね、マインドセットが出来上がってきました。まあ、それゆえに我々は、自宅を片付けるのに非常に有効な手段ですのでご用命をいただけていると。
As per the company, visits to people's homes surged by 31% to 20,990 in October. Three quarters of its customers are in their 50s or older, selling kimonos, luxury handbags and jewelry. Cooks from across the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region participated in a culinary competition in an effort to raise public attention to the city's catering industry and better promote its cooking culture. The COVID-19 pandemic has greatly affected many industries around the world, including Hong Kong's catering industry, as it faces a transformation to survive. With the government tightening pandemic measures, the catering industry is now actively integrating into the Greater Bay Area through skills training, transformation and upgrading, and seeking new development opportunities. Yeah. 16 Iraqi women in the city of Basra are breaking stereotypes in the conservative Iraqi society by being a part of a wrestling team. Iraqi coach Abdul Karim Gadwan, who founded the team after moving back to his country from Denmark, said the biggest obstacle to overcome was convincing families to allow their daughters to join the team.
أغم هاي كلها تخطينا هاي الأمور كلها وقعدنا ويا العوائل أولياء أم البنات وتكلمنا وياهم وشرحنا لهم الوضعية إنه هذا فريق نسوي إحنا ما عدنا فريق نسوي وأغلب اللاعبات إنهم أساس إن عوائلهم رياضيين ما فهموا هاي الوضعية.
In order to ease their concerns, Gadwan ensured that the women's transportation was accounted for and that he would coach them verbally, demonstrating all moves with a male player. After forming the team in 2018, Gadwan says more than a dozen women between the ages of 8 and 25 have joined the team. He covers all the costs of training. So far, the team has participated in two local championships and won a gold medal in the Arab Championship held in Sulaymaniyah in 2019.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.